And there will be some live coverage over that thing. An opening statement is a final opening statement is being prepared for you to look at. Other than that, we plan to start with foreign and try to spend about 20 minutes, and then domestic about 20 minutes, and then save a few minutes to take general questions.
All right. Do I intend to veto in September the expected House Senate bill imposing limited sanctions on South Africa? Well, I never discuss what I will or not veto, except in broad terms of such as overall policy, such as tax cuts. But I will express my feeling that sanctions would not be productive, indeed would be counterproductive in South Africa. We have had successes. There have been improvements. And we believe that simply walk away would penalize the very people that we want to help, namely the blacks, as well as a number of surrounding black countries in Africa that are totally dependent for their economies on their exchange of trade with South Africa. Enough?
It's a very good statement. It's useful to maybe acknowledge the statements of Chief Kwivalezi over the weekend. He pointed out that
I had turned that magazine around in circles trying to figure what the extra leg is or how that photograph makes it look that way. Isn't that amazing?
It's exactly what he's got.
Yes.
The other display I just wanted to show you if you haven't seen it. This happens to be a layout of that cardboard cutout of me outside.
Oh, yes, you are.
You get all these pictures taken. But I thought that to prove that age is only in a fellow's mind, I want you to know it's that
okay. Okay, so what do I do?
All right, let's move in.
Okay, show me how to start. No, the Oscar. All right, the general. I don't think I can
do that. Sorry. That's too mechanical.
I know. Okay. A little sorry. It's been going on all the way.
All right.
And.
You don't need that, Mr. President.
Good evening. President Murray. Hi. Good morning. Glad to see you.
Well, come in.
It was a great last night.
Well, thank you.
Good to see you.
Hi.
Well, later. I didn't like it. Yul Brynner was starring in.
Was he playing the King of Siam?
I can't remember what he was playing, but when we had baseball here,
well,
I went out on two evenings for two afternoons, two ball games. Football, I've gone to one football game here, and that was West Virginia played Maryland. I just went at the halftime to crown West Virginia Queen.
You're a real fan. Well, Robert. Well, now you're going on another kind of entertainment trip.
Yes,
sir. And listen, of course, greeting and express our hopes that the November meeting will result in, we hope, an agenda for the future for dealing with the various problems and all. And I think that if you expressed our...
Department has to be audited by IRS going back 3 years.
I'm not dodging that. $1,000
I want everybody here to kind of feel aggrieved to know that I will appoint you. I too am audited regularly.
That's not a refund, I'm very good at new accounting. Mr. President, this is a non-decisional meeting, really, of your economic policies have resulted, has resulted in historically high and politically unsustainable, some would say economically unsustainable, but certainly politically unsustainable trade deficits. Trade, I think, is becoming, if it hasn't already become, one of the cutting issues, one of the cutting political issues of 1986, and it's going to be heavily involved, I think, in the 1986 campaigns. I think evidence of that is what happened down in Texas last week in that first congressional district special election where we thought we might elect a Republican.
Actual meeting here. I'm going to sign an executive order establishing a presidential board of advisors on private sector initiatives. You all know the high priority that we placed on private solutions to public problems. And this board will help meet the challenge before us, I'm sure, by promoting corporate community involvement and public and private partnerships and privatization and volunteerism. Over the 4 years, we've accomplished a great deal. And we did it first with the help of the PSI Task Force, most recently with the Advisory Council. But there's a lot to be done. I'm going to need all of your support on this. I think it's been one of the great things we've had for 4 years. And I'll be announcing the members of the Advisory Board later on.
Thank you, Mr. President. Before we get into that, I just might mention very briefly that about an hour ago, the Vice President announced before a press conference that your first regulatory program, the regulatory plan, has just been produced and is going to be released. That's right, the Federal Register. It's going to be released today. And Mr. President, what this does is it's been a kind of a painful process between OMB and all the agencies. We appreciate your graceful cooperation. And what this does is this forecasts 1 year ahead of time what the regulatory plans are of the agencies. This should be a great benefit not only to the executive office of the president being able to review them, but also to the cabinet officers, because in many cases what we're having problems with during the first 3 to 4 years was the fact that everybody was getting taken by surprise. When these things were coming flying out of the woodwork at the last minute when we got boxed. One of the criticisms is going to be that this is a way to where we are not going to be making public many of the plans before they come into the Federal Register. It is exactly the reverse. It is published 1 year ahead of time for everybody to see. Mr. Vice President, I don't
know. I understand you to say that's the budget?
This is, yeah, it looks like it. This is the regulatory program.
Oh, the regulatory.
That's right. It was announced today.
I was going to say, I was a little worried because in California our budget was twice as thick as that.
Right. Now this, Mr. President, was given out over there at a press conference today. I left courageously before the questioning began, but some people on the Hill, some of the staffs, particularly Dingell's, are upset, and they think this is restricting their ability to criticize and ability to shape the regulations. And what we're trying to do, and OMB in the lead, is to simplify, to be sure that people that you have appointed work together. And sometimes we've had examples of one agency going off in one direction with regulations, another going in another way. So it's coordinative as well as, it's gonna keep an economic
through OMB, keep an economic target, so we just don't start going down the road that we inherited when we came in. It's a good step, and they've done an awful lot of work on it.
But if they think we're trying to curb their ability to regulate, we are.
We phrased it differently, but nevertheless, I think it was very well received by them.
Okay, what you have in front of you is a fiscal 86 budget update after the Congressional Budget Compromise was passed, as well as some preliminary ideas starting the fiscal 87 budget process that we are just embarking on.
Standing stark naked in the middle of the day in the bedroom. I said, what in the world are you doing?
I started up.
She said, no clothes, none at all. He goes open to opens the closet, yellow dress, red dress, blue dress, hello, Mark, white dress.
I found her in the bedroom, same thing, you know. Start naked here on that.
Start over.
Well, I'm going back to a hard day working. He comes in the house, his wife is not there immediately with his slippers and walking like every good wife should be. Goes into the kitchen. She's not there either, whatever wife should be, preparing the meal, goes in the bedroom, and finally sees her standing next to a mirror, dressed down, looking at, admiring her upper body. Well, what are you doing? And she said, well, I just had a physical today, and my doctor said that the most attractive body of anybody my age, I've got the body of a 23-year-old. He said, what did he say about your 50-year-old ass? Oh, he didn't mention your name. Show the story that you can turn around so the women will even win the one.
That was Roman numeral one.
The cleanest joke Gabriel's ever told.
Well, Mr. President, we have a regular meeting coming up here for you with the Joint Chiefs, and we